Mr. Mudana Sri Sai Chakran Satya to share with us from India? Is it Mr. Mudana Satya here or?
He's absent.
He's absent. Okay, yeah. Thank you. Now I have seen Dmitrio from Ukraine. So please take the floor and share with us your presentation on current state and determination of prospects for the development of organic production in Ukraine. Thank you.
Hello, as I understand, you can see me, yes?
I see you are present, but however, you should share your screen with us.
Yes, I'll share the screen, but camera mine doesn't work. I don't know why.
Your camera doesn't work, indeed.
What about but I've your turned partner? It on. What about your partner, Irina?
Yes, here is me and Irina also is today with us. Can you see the screen?
Yes. Yes, the screen is already shared with us. Just click on the full screen option.
Wait. Come to the full screen. No, some problem. Let it stay as it.
Please press F5, function key 5, F5. Press F5 on your keyboard. On your keyboard, you press F5.
F5, yes. Oh, yes, here it is.
Yes. Okay, yes. So it's visible. Please.
Yes.
You have 10 minutes.
First of all, I want to thank the organizers for the event. Very interesting presentations and very actual topics. I was present for the whole day today and previously very interesting. Thank you. As for my topic, I want to tell that the attention of the world community to organic products is steadily growing. The organic market has one of the most dynamic food markets in the world for about 2 decades and is becoming a popular alternative to consuming traditional products. The attitude is due not only to human concern for the environment, but also to the care of own health. Ukraine does not stand aside from this trend. According to program documents, organic agriculture is a priority for Ukraine. The proclamation by the Constitution of Ukraine of a person, his life, health, and safety as the highest social value presupposes and determines the necessity, formation, and development of an organic direction in agriculture, which is an integral part of the state agro-industrial policy. The development of the organic direction is promising not only in terms of commerce, but also the opportunity to improve and restore the condition of soils of Ukraine. Organic market experts confidently state that Ukraine has all the prerequisites to become an organic hub for the European market. Over the past 5 years, organic production has increased by 90%. The area of organic agricultural lands has increased from 260,000 hectares to 468,000 hectares. Ukraine now ranks 20th in the world and 12th in the Europe in the area of land occupied by organic agriculture. We observe positive trend also organic agriculture. The number of organic producers has increased almost 7 times compared to 2006. Significant increase was recorded during 2018 and 2020 year. The main European consumers of Ukrainian organic products are the Netherlands, Germany, Switzerland, Italy, United Kingdom, Austria, Poland, Czech Republic, France, Hungary, Romania, Belgium, Lithuania, and Denmark. According to the results of 2020, Ukraine ranked fourth among the largest countries exporting organic products to the European Union. In recent years, the geography of Ukrainian organic exports has expanded, and the key imported countries have also changed. In general, if in previous exports to European countries amounted to more than 85%, then in 2020 it decreased to 73%. At the same time, the share of exports to the North America, the USA and Canada has expanded to 24%. In this regard, we believe that the development of domestic brands and certified organic products, their promotion on the national market, as well as exports of to foreign countries, is strategically important for our country. However, despite the significant prospects for the expansion of domestic market of organic production, there are some obstacles that hinder the development of organic agriculture. Respectively, they can be grouped in the three major groups: the social, psychological, institutional, and legal, and financial and economical. Socio-psychological are divided into external and internal. The external ones are low incomes, existing stereotypes of human behavior, and the existing culture of consumption of goods and services, insufficient public awareness of the properties of organic products and their differences from traditional products. The internal ones include research, education, and consulting on organic production in Ukraine at an early stage. The lack of sufficient number of qualified specialists in this field of organic production. Institutional and legal ones are also can be divided into external and internal. External ones include imperfection of the existing regulatory framework governing the activities of organic operators, incomplete land reform and no transparent market for agricultural land, the lack of a single certification system for producers of organic agricultural products, small number of elements of internal infrastructure, difficulties in selling organic products on the domestic market due to the lack of processing and marketing enterprises. The internal ones include low level of cooperation of local, regional and local councils, research institutes and universities on organic productions, production with organizations and state institutions at the state and local levels. Financial and economic obstacles can be divided also into external and internal. The external ones include poorly developed domestic market of organic vegetables and fruits, livestock products, a wide range of agricultural product grown according to the traditional scheme as opposed to organic, the lack of public financial support during the conversion period and the provision of benefits of subscribers of organic varieties. As internal should be considered, lack of sufficient marketing research for organic markets, financial losses due to a decrease in output, financial costs associated with the need to purchase special machinery and equipment. The conversion period may last up to 3 years, which is a kind of risk for the organic producers and additional cost. Solving these problems will allow to form an effective infrastructure of the organic market and improve state regulation of production, which is a result will ensure environmental safety of agriculture, improve product quality, preserve and improve soil quality, environmental protection and biodiversity, create favorable conditions for balanced development of rural territories. The success of agribusiness development in the field of organic production largely depends on the quality of legal support, on the legal support, economic feasibility for both producers and consumers, and proper government support. The state must guarantee the safety and quality of organic products. This area activity should include setting clear standards and requirements for organic agricultural products, improving the system of state control over the quality and compliance with standards of organic products, in order to protect the rights of consumers, harmonization of national quality standards with international ones, introduction of a national system of certification and labeling of organic agricultural products. It should be noted that Ukraine insufficient attention is paid to the implementation of the concept of environmentally friendly production due to the country's intentions to obtain the status of a member of the European Union, whose legislation is characterized by strict regulation of production and the circulation of organic food. At the same time, the level of state support for the development of organic agriculture should guarantee its profitability and competitiveness in domestic and foreign agricultural markets. But despite the circumstance, the financing of support of agro-industrial complex is still poor in Ukraine. Therefore, stimulating the development of organic agricultural production requires a comprehensive approach. At the state level, the implementation of all incentives requires considerable effort and material support, which leads to the complexity of this issue. Thank you.
Thank you. I understand that this was your presentation, Dimitro, and of your colleague Irina Ignatenko.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing with us the status of organic farming in Ukraine, organic production. And now,